game kung saan sobrang lakas na ni Granger at ni Beatrix, it's gonna be scary. Also, last thing, I'm sorry about this, but you need to also take note dun sa objective taking potential ng Beatrix. Ang bilis mang tunaw ng Tore, pati na rin ng Lord at ng Turtle.
So, mukhang fast game ang hanap ni Omega dito for that matter. As we go into game number 3, it's a best of 3 series. The final game of the day and the final, literally the final game of the day. Wala na tayong series to follow. Bukas na ulit yung ibang laban. And it is Beatrix on the gold lane. Pakito on the EXP lane.
Man, I like the adjustment mula sa LPE. So, na-mention natin kanina na pwede siyang gold lane Chang'e. At indeed, ganun nga yung mangyayari. So, si Arms, instead na mag-Chang'e siya, siya na yung Sylvana, na alam natin na pwede sila magpalitan. Nung first pick Benedetta mula sa LPE, nag-decide sila, okay, sige, si Bimo na lang yung gagamit as the roaming Benedetta. And this allows LPE na magkaroon ng sobrang taas ng damage output sa lahat ng stages ng game natin, early until the late game, dahil sa coverage na meron ang isang Chang'e, Chang'e, Yi Sun Shin, and Barat's combo.
And on the side of Omega here, you said it best na Beatrix is an objective killer. Matutunan niya yung objectives. And all Toshi needs right now is to get a lot of space. And speaking of space, Bimo does not have a lot of space to move around here. Ars gets a stun onto Kenji just to keep him alive. And they manage to not secure the orange buff for themselves. But at the same time, nobody really falls down there.
Yep. Mahirapan din dito si GZ kasi may nakakabwisit na Benedetta na humahabol-habol sa kanya. If you imagine, Aspex level 4, halfway papuntan level 5 at si GZ ngayon pala magsisimula sa kanyang purple buff. Ryota, dumalo pa para lang din talaga mag-reset. It's gonna be annoying. Unlike yung previous games natin na yung Granger ay nagkaroon ng free farm sa early stages, this time, mahihirapan siya GZ. Yun na si Bimo.
Oh, diving into Bimo's the current Electro Final. Low, just to secure the kill, pero actually, it was Ars that secures that for himself. And Haze and Cortese wants to go for a trade. It is a 1-for-2 trade in favor of Omega.
Oh man, I can't imagine kung gano'ng kahirap ito para kay GZ. You have Sylvana na lakas mang gulo. Meron ka pa din na roaming Benedetta. It's gonna be difficult para sa Granger. In fact, kanina, nung nag-level 4 na si Bimo sa kanyang, sa kanyang Benedetta, meron siyang ultimate. Almost level 4 pa lang si GZ nun. Kaya hindi siya nakakontra with the Death Sonata. Kahit nasa likod siya ng kanyang second turret, kinapos pa rin. Malaki na ang difference ni Aspect pati na rin ni GZ. This is really looking good para sa LPE.
And this is all thanks to the invades na ginagawa ng LPE dito. High impact invades that hindi nahihirapan na si GZ. Paulit-ulit na sasabihin dito as Haze flickers in towards the backlines of Ars and Jake the Doppler. Here comes the Meteor Shower. Aspect will actually fall down there. Omega trying to fight back in this game. The Electro Final Blow will not connect to anybody. Cortese and Haze will fall back. Aspect, the only one going down as well as Toshi.
The classic combo ng LPE. Minsan ginagamit nila yung Chang'e kay Arms. Minsan din naman ay kay Jake the Dog. But it is the same. Imperial Justice, pati na rin Meteor Showers. Shoot na shoot. Wala nagawa yung Omega. They dealt damage gamit yung Beatrix. Nakawasan lang isang return kill. But we'll see na masayang-masaya si Jake the Dog sa nangyayari na to dahil lamang na siya over Toshi in their matchup.
And another thing to point out here, the Yi Sun Shin pickups guarantees na alam kaagad nila kung saan pupunta si GZ. And as long as alam nila kung saan si GZ, alam nila kung saan sila iiwas, alam nila kung saan at kailan sila pwede mag-invade. As Ryota kinain si Kenji, Kenji is will be able to escape barely with his life.
Okay. Hindi rin inatake ng Tore masyado si Kenji kasi mabilis na maglahat. And Kenji did not hit the Barracks first. Do take note, mayroong mga minions are under the turret. So, medyo wasted ultimate kami from Ryota, pati na rin yung Flicker. And Omega, confident sila ngayon mag-take ng Turtle. Or should they be confident though? Yan ang tatlo.
Should they be? Bimo pops the Electro Final Blow, eyeing out GZ, gets the stun up connection, and GZ will fall down. Granger is out. Glorious Pathway, defensive usage there. Semi-aggressive as well from Haze. Will manage to secure two other kills onto Arms into Aspect. It's just Jake the Dog alive in this team fight. Ryota in the back line, surrounded by four members. Mukhang wala siyang matatakasan. Gets one bite off of it to try to get the turn aggro onto Kenji, pero ang sobrang kunat nga niya.
Oh, without damage, Kenji, he knows na mamahuli din talaga siya, kaya hindi siya umatake dun sa Barats, which also meant na hindi siya yung antanatore. Nice juggling from OMG,
oh,
from Mega Esports. Bimo? Yeah, roaming Benedetta, not much damage, but did have the execute though, pero makunat na ngayon si Kenji.
And unting-unting na lumalabas yung problema ng LP dito. It is the Kenji. It's not Hajizi for that matter. It's Haze and Kenji. As I say that, Toshi goes down. And we haven't seen an objective being secured by Omega just yet.
Oh, maganda yung kill na nakuha ng Omega. Tatlo dun para kay Toshi. But the fight afterwards, nako, nag-favor talaga si LP and Haze. Flicker forward, okay.
Commits the Glorious Pathway para kay Curtizzi to take the kill onto ours, pero Jake the Dog will just have to use that meteor shower.
Literally walking out of there, LPE. Parang, well, man din sila masyadong ginawa. Parang cover fire lang, coming up from meteor shower, but ang daming ginamit na important resources mula sa Omega. Flicker ay isang resource. Imagine having, what, 1 minute and 30 seconds na wala kang Flicker on your tank, tapos you also committed yung yin yang overturn and the glorious pathway din. So weird na decision mula sa OMG.
Weird decision making here indeed. Alam nila na they have to secure kills, pero it wasn't really effective for themselves. No. Na they had a good idea on the top lane, pero they weren't actually expecting a full three-man lineup. I mean, they weren't actually expecting three members from LP in that tribe rush. And that costs the, well, not actually costs the life here, but the HPs are dangerously low here for the rest of the members of LPE. Sila pa yung nadehado dun sa fight na yun. But they do manage to get the turret off of that.
Oh.
Arv just buying a lot of time, manages to dash out. Bimo, nandiyan parang tumulong.
Oh my
gets
God.
The dive in. Ryota looking for an opportunity, and Bimo's gonna be playing the prize. Commits the Electro Final Blow a bit too early.
Questionable plays for both teams. I mean, Arms was already trying to buying a lot of time. Ang daming naubos na oras. And then Bimo tried to jump in as well. Hindi naman ganun din ka-punishing though. Kasi ang kagandaan sa nakuha ng LPE is nakapag-push to Barats sa may lane na yun. However, OMG having the first try at this turtle. Nakita nga lang sila with this Mountain Shocker. So, ang trade-off yata para sa LPE. Going for the top lane turret in exchange for the turtle.
And it's almost always going to be the turret here. Kasi LPE now has a wide open map. Kaya nilang i-take kagad yung jungle ng Omega dito. More resources out there. And Arvs, it's taken out. Next,
Toshi might be in trouble.
He is going to be in trouble, but he's relatively safe. Haze is the one that has to be in trouble. Gets gobbled up by Ryota. And there's not a lot of positioning here for LP to really follow it through. Omega going to oblige with a kill onto Bimo. Another kill on the board for Toshi, and they are on the chase. Gets a flicker into Ryota. Ryota will get taken out, and it's this bottom lane turret na ina-eye out na Omega to even out the map.
BOD na picked up by Toshi. Yung haba ng fight na yon na awkward para sa presa teams. Might get an exit kill kay Jake the Dog.
Might, but the meteor shower is deterring them from pushing any forward.
Oh, Aspect, maganda yung pwesto. Oh, against four.
Mountain Shocker. Beautiful damage out, but will get the kill onto Haze. But the HPs are low. Arms ata nagigigil siya.
Oh man, it's ang weird and unfortunate ng turn of events for actually both teams.
Flicker
pero mas maganda yun.
Gets the catch. Aspect looking for the wipeout, and he does get the cleanup there. The shutdown
oh
as well.
Oh my God. Arms, napakagandang talon nun using the flicker. No match at all. May return kill ba?
Medyo alang-ani pa i-return kill na gusto mong mangyari ng Omega dito. Kasi Jake the Dog, always beautiful timing on that meteor shower.
Oh
but
my
Toshi!
God!
Damage output way too much onto Jake the Dog in Aspect.
Oh, but Ryota. Unstoppable clashes, Nomad.
Non-stop clashes here. Ryota and Bimo wanted to go for Kenji and or Toshi.
Okay, so I was gonna say unfortunate events for Omega, tapos biglang unfortunate events para sa LPE. Para sa teams nagkaroon ng mga brilliant plays, pero nagkaroon din sila ng mga questionable plays. So palitan lang din. But then again, LPE, dahil sa fact na kuha sila ng apat na tore, isang tore lang para sa Omega, sa kanila natin ibibigay talaga ang early stages. So like in the first 9 minutes, gonna be favoring them and tingnan naman natin lamang ng 600 gold lang naman ating isang Chilla Bird Ranger, pero si Toshi 6.6k, ang kanya katapat which is Jake the Dog is just 5.7k. So sabihin na natin hindi ganun kagandang economy ng support sa OMG, pero yung kanilang mga cores against LPE having a good time.
And we're already reaching a point na paunting-unting sumasakit na si Haji sa even more so si Toshi.
Yeah. And dadating sa point na ang Omega mas malakas sila sa late game dahil sa kanilang raw damage output. Sabihin na natin ang LPE meron silang sustain. Pinili ni Ryota is the helmet into double helmet eh. Sky Guardian helmet tas cursed helmet. So makunat talaga itong ating Barats. Come a point though na baka kulangan sila ng damage unless dumating si Jake the Dog sa critical mass kung saan kaya na niya mag-burst down using the meteor shower.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of meteor shower, it is being saved out just yet kasi LPE gusto nilang kunin yung Lord. Omega does not want to give them the Lord and they're already in position to secure the Lord themselves. Medyo tag of war yung nangyayari din sa laban natin ngayon, Wolf.
Yeah, it is definitely a tag of war. 9 minutes in. Hindi kahit sinong team dito, hindi kayang ibigay, hindi afford na ibigay yung Lord over the other team. Sobrang crucial. At tingnan mo yung burst. We were talking about this, kung gano'ng kabilis mang shred ng Tore, pati na rin ng Lord ang isang Beatrix. Give him a little bit of opening lang. Nako, mabilis yan. That's why LPE are respecting this. Hindi sila nagbawapok, pero kakasabi ko lang.
Hindi nila nirespeto ang bush. And look at the damage output from LPE. The Mountain Shockers as well reveals the location of Omega. The Glorious Pathway will be used defensively para mabuhay sila doon. A one-for-one trade. Omega slowly getting back into the game.
Two mid laners. Flickers committed kay Ryota. And a lot of battle spells din para sa Omega. So I think LPE are feeling confident now.
Feeling very confident. It's just Kenji and Haji to contest this Lord. And let's take Kenji out of the equation as well.
And that's a bad decision para sa Omega. Giving up yung kanilang EXP laner. Which also means, again, confident ulit ang LPE. Nakamit nila yung meteor shower nila with that kill. But I think that at that moment ay goods na yun para sa kanilang team. Bimo, ang ganda ng pwestuhan for scouting. At hindi rin nagpapatay.
That is also an aggressive Glorious Pathway committed by Haze. Pero wala mismo nag-follow through. And that does apply the slow onto LPE. But it's not slowing them down with this team fight.
Wow. LPE. The better decision making dun sa Lord area. Kaya have to think back yung Omega dito one after another. Hindi sila ganun ka-synchronized. Bimo back dun sa kanyang pwesto kanina. Now Curtizzi. Keeping his hands there.
Looking for an opening, Omega will try to go Lord. For the steal. Lord will be secured by LPE. And with that being said, the meteor shower will be committed as well to deter Haji's Omega down. From looking for a fight. And yes, Haji is down. That's one burst damage out of the equation for Omega.
Simple mathematics yung LPE. 4 versus 5 yung fight around the Lord area. Hindi nga actually naging 4v5 kasi yung ibang members pa ng Omega ay hindi handa nung tinry na gumawa ng play ng ibang members ng Omega. Bimo, napaganda nung pwesto 1 around dun sa Kramer area. Dun sa may top lane, makita nyo yung parang beetle na jungle creep. Dalawang beses siyang nandun at hindi man siya nakakuha ng kahit anong stun or initiation. Yung fact lang na alam niya kung nasa yung mga members ng Omega, that's already enough. At napapakomit din yung Omega dun sa tank natin na si Bimo. Kaya naman din effective paminsan-minsan ang isang roaming Benedetta. And now Omega, they're in trouble.
They are in trouble. This is a throwback to game number one where LPE is already sieging up. Beautiful entry there by Arvs. HP already low from Toshi. Force it back off. Yung damage output na meron si Toshi, hindi niya masyado na-apply kasi lagi siya na-burst out. Kailangan niya bumalik agad para mag-reset.
That's right.
And now the siege for the mid lane is happening as well. They will not be able to secure this, pero they have to fear the fact na yung LPE nasa labas na ng bahay ng Omega.
So you see, yung magagandang talon dito ng LPE, kaya natin masasabing maganda sa like kasi nagugulo nila yung backlines, nakaka-achieve sila ng pag-take ng objectives at hindi lang yan, nakakaalis sila safely. Another jump from Arms.
Another Glorious Pathway committed. Hopefully, this is going to be the aggressive play from Omega. Pero again, beautiful timing by Jake the Dog. Hindi niya basta-basta binibitawan yung Meteor Shower.
Oh, look at this decision from LPE going for defensive items. Kaya ang kukunat nila. And even with jumps, hindi sila napapatay kahit ang taas ng burst potential ng Omega.
Bimo in the backlines. Electro final blow. Connecting on the two. Catching Haji.
Oh my God,
Haji. Betting control out. by Toshi.
Oh my goodness.
The meteor shower, just to add a little bit of salt.
I am dumbfounded. Ang ganda nung kontra dun ni Hajizi. I honestly thought na dead to rights na sina drop from BMO's jump, tapos may initiation din from other members of LPE. Pero instead na bumak ng totally, sumindstep siya ng konti, papunta dun sa kanan from our field of vision. And that meant na nabuhay siya. Ginamit din niya yung ultimate kasi meron kang konting recoil coming out from the Death Sonata, di ba? Meron kang konting atras or, you know, meron kang konting roll when you're doing it. Ginamit din niya yung to his advantage after the rondo. Very smart usage ng kanyang Granger.
And again, wonderful usage of the Mountain Shocker to get information kung nasaan yung Omega sa mapa. And they know for a fact they are on the top side. They will be creating a lot of space. LPE will be creating a lot of space for themselves to deprive Haji, deprive Toshi of any farms.
Oh. I like this. Omega, nagpapakita ng veteran moves on their defense, pero yung LPE, parang talagang contender yung kanilang mindset. Especially with how they are performing, yung pwesto dito ni BMO, makikita mo na maganda talaga yung communication ng LPE as a team kasi bawat galaw nila ay may parang plano before it happens. And now they're in control. Sabihin na natin na hindi ganun kataas yung kanilang damage output, kung banggaan lang ang usapan, pero the way that they're playing it and yung pag-maximize nila ng mga heroes nila sa pwestuhan, sa timing, it makes it so na mas maganda yung kanilang itsura when the teamfights do happen.
And yung itsura ng Omega dito, OMG na lang sila. Kasi ang hirap na ng pwesto nila. Two inhibitor turrets are down. Mm-hmm. Only one turret left dun sa base nila. And if that falls down, mas madali na yung push ng LP to end the game. Omega needs to secure the upcoming Lord. Yeah. Pero LP has the priority.
Gotta have to take note. Meron kang Glaive. Meron ka pang Holy Crystal doon sa ating Chango. Masakit na yung damage ng Chango ngayon. And positioning na naman. Vision pati ng Mountain Shocker allows LPE to be comfortable taking this Lord.
And the dive in from Haze. Glorious Pathway will not be committed. He gets stunned completely. Meanwhile, over in the backside of things, Arms, the help of the Lord gets the knockup. And OMG is turning the tides of this fight. Ryota. Oh, wait. No. BMO will be actually go for
BMO
the
flip. With the
he is going to go for the place. And what LPE is doing is they're just delaying the fact. Na kailangan nila mag-fallback. And mukhang BMO, the one and army.
Toshi
has to burst this minion down.
Oh
and
my god.
Like now. Oh. Still is there. Ryota is going to finish it. What a wonderful way to end the day.
BMO.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god, indeed. Yun na lang siguro pwedeng sabihin ng OMG dun sa moment na yun. Kusabi, my god.
Oh my god. This winning moment is brought to you by Master. Hindi sila na GG, instead they brought their clay game with Master. Sikreto ng mga gwapo at napakagwapo nga talaga ng standing nila dito sa laban na to.
You can't have words for that. BMO, roll.